Hi, in this tutorial we will learn how to create this simple chair, and during this tutorial we will learn many tools and techniques on how to deal with this kind of geometry. And in the beginning we will start with the upper part and then go down. So let's get started. First, for the units, customize unit setup. I'm working with centimeters for the display unit and also centimeters for the system units. Go to shapes, rectangle, for the width I'm gonna choose 52. For the length, 46, let's say. And I will center this rectangle. Convert to irritable spline. And now I will fillet those vertices. I will create a copy from this using Ctrl V for clone, copy. Move it up 35 centimeters. I will move everything up for 40 centimeters. I don't need this segment here, so I will delete it. Okay, now I will select those vertices. I will convert these vertices to corner and extrude 2.5, shell to the outside, I will make it 3, a couple of extrusions. Now I will select these these polygons. Extrude 2.5. Segment, and I will pull these back a little. I will move these a little bit to the front. Again, edge, Alt R to create a ring. I will add two loops. Here I will create this detail. Extrude. Select these edges here and scale them in the X. If the scale doesn't work, here you should change it to selection center, because if by default it's pivot point center, it will not work. So be aware of this thing. Now I will continue with this detail here. Inset. Then extrude. Snap constraint. Now let's add these two verticals here that goes down. Now we can eyeball it, but if you like to be precise, I can use this trick. I can create a rectangle here. In the top view, create a circle. Make it small. I will center it on XYZ. I don't need the rectangle now. Maybe a little bit bigger. Make a copy, shift, drag, copy. This one I will make it bigger. There's a multiple ways to create this, but let's learn this thing here. I will convert this to editable poly, attach. Here, the positive side is in this direction. I want to flip it, because I want to create a bridge between this face, this polygon, and this polygon, and the positive sides should face each other. This is the positive side here, the front of the face. So I will select both polygons. And create a bridge. Now let's continue finalizing this part here. If I add a turbo smooth, you can see that we need to have some edge loops to constrain the smoothness in certain areas. So I will add an edge loop here. Small one here. Here there is a small fillet. And here. Here. Now, I didn't fix this part because now I can use symmetry on the X, flip, I can go here and attach this part here. I will fix a small thing here. I think it's better for this part to move a little bit so it's not like this, even though I can keep it like this, but okay. Just a little bit. Before ending the first part, I like to go back here and add an edge loop here. So that's it for this first part. I will upload the second one shortly after this one. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, please press the like button and subscribe to the channel. And see you in the next part. Thank you.